flu a century ago is now a weapon in the battle against coronavirus, but does it work? Here's CBS 2's Dick Brennan.
Look at all that plasma. Russ Camarda made it through COVID-19 and decided to donate his plasma to the New York Blood Center. We first met Russ last month when he was just recovering from the illness.
It was pretty brutal. It was a beast. It was a monster.
It's been 5 weeks. How are you feeling now?
I feel much better.
The coronavirus was a terrifying 16-day ordeal for Camarda, and he wanted some good to come out of it.
Why did you do it?
You felt so defeated and so frightened by what your prospects were when you were sick that you wanted something to feel like a victory, something to feel like you could contribute.
Camarda says the process was painless and only took about 30 minutes. The idea? Take the plasma from the blood of someone who's recovered from the virus and give it to a patient still fighting it. The antibodies in the plasma then fight the illness.
The convalescent plasma program is a phenomenal response in a wartime effort for extreme cases.
Using plasma to fight disease goes back 100 years, but it only very recently has been employed against the coronavirus.
We still don't know if convalescent plasma is an effective treatment against COVID-19, but they're using it more and more in the acutely ill because there's no effective treatments.
And demand for the plasma is so high because so much is needed for one treatment.
The blood bank has to put together the plasma from up to 10, maybe sometimes 12 people to get enough antibodies to transfuse to one person.
So every donation matters. And because he made it through, Russ Camarda wants someone else to make it too.
I am super grateful to be alive and breathing and walking in the sun, enjoying the spring. When I thought, you know, I might not have that chance.
So now the chance to pay it forward in hopes of saving a life. Dick Brennan, CBS 2 News.